Another area we are going to look into now is anatomy. And we are going to look at anatomy in animals and plants. And anatomy is simply the structure of the organism and how the structure functions in the body. Anatomy. Anatomy is the science of structures, organs, and systems, and how they function in the body of organisms. In anatomy, we have questions like, how does the brain function? What do the various parts of the brain do? How is the heart structured to function? And so on. Example 1. In that section, the rib cage of a mammal has to be opened to expose the A, diaphragm, B, heart, C, liver, D, sternum. Option A is a muscle that separates the abdominal cavity from the thoracic cavity. The thoracic cavity is the cavity that the rib cage encloses. So the diaphragm, you don't need to open the rib cage to see the diaphragm. C is the liver. Liver is below the diaphragm, just on top of the stomach. And D is sternum. Sternum is breast bone, which is part of the rib cage. So the organ that needs to be exposed inside the rib cage is the heart. So option B is the answer. The function of the vibrissae in rabbit is A, photosensitive, B, radiosensitive, C, chemoreceptive, and D, tactile. Vibrissae is another name for whiskers, the whiskers of rabbits. We know that the rabbit uses the whisker to trace its path inside a dark tunnel, because immediately it touches the wall of the tunnel, it will know that the wall is there. So the answer is tactile, that is touch, for touch, sensitive to touch. Number 3, the sheet of muscle that separates thoracic and abdominal cavities is the A, intercostal muscle, B, pleural membrane, C, pericardium, and D, diaphragm. Intercostal muscle is a muscle that surrounds the ribs, the one that needs to contract for the ribs to move outward and upward. Then B, pleural membrane. This is the membrane that wraps the lungs and makes the thoracic cavity to be airtight for the lungs to function. C, pericardium is the membrane that encloses the heart with fluid to reduce friction and protect the heart. Then D is diaphragm, the one that separates the thoracic cavity from abdominal cavity. So answer to number 3 is D. Number 4, which of the following organs regulates the level of water, salt, hydrogen ions, and urea in the mammalian blood? A, kidney, B, liver, C, bladder, and D, colon. We are looking for the organ that is regulating the water level of the blood, the salt concentration, hydrogen ion, and the urea. Colon is part of the large intestine. The only thing we know function there in man is reabsorption of water from the fecal material, that is undigested solid waste. The bladder here is assumed to be urinary bladder. It's only just to accommodate the urine produced by kidney. that is that taken to it through the ureter. When it feed up, then it pass it out through the urethra, and that is its function. Then the liver, its own is to regulate the sugar level of the blood, and also help in deamination and other functions like storage of vitamins and sorts. But in actual regulation, we have the kidney removing urea, in the process remove water, salt, and hydrogen ions from the blood. So we say the functions of the kidney include excretory, osmoregulatory, and pH control. So the appropriate answer here is A, the kidney. Number 5, the heart of the adult frog consists of A, 2 auricles and 2 ventricles, B, 1 auricle and 1 ventricle, C, 2 ventricles and 1 auricles, D, 1 ventricle and 2 auricles. The study has shown that the heart is evolving gradually from fish down to mammals. In fish, we have only one atrium and what we call a simple atrium. The ventricle is not even strong, so we can say one. A frog, it is one, we have two auricles at the top and one ventricle pumping the blood out. So answer is D.